This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Elsevier Dutch Pronunciation is one of the world's major providers of scientific, technical, and medical information, and a technology company originally established in 1880. It is now a part of the RELX Group, known until 2015 as Reed Elsevier. Its products include journals such as The Lancet and Cell, the ScienceDirect collection of electronic journals, the Trends and Current Opinion series of journals, and the online citation database Scopus. Elsevier publishes approximately 400,000 articles annually. In 2,500 journals, its archives contain over 13 million documents and 30,000 e-books. Total yearly downloads amount to 900 million. Elsevier's high profit margins 37% in 2015 and its copyright practices have subjected it to criticism by researchers. Contents 1 History 2 Company Statistics 3 Operating Structure 31 Global Conferences 4 Corporate Affairs 41 Corporate Social Responsibility 5 Criticism and Controversies 51 Pricing 52 Resignation of Editorial Boards 53 Action Against Academics Posting Their Own Articles Online 54 Chaos, Solitons. History Elsevier was founded in 1880 and took the name from the Dutch publishing house Elsevier, which has no connection with the present company. The Elsevier family operated as booksellers and publishers in the Netherlands. The founder, Lodewijk Elsevier 1542-1617, lived in Leiden and established the business in 1580. The expansion of Elsevier in the scientific field after 1945 was funded with the profits of the newsweekly Elsevier, which first issue appeared on the 27th of October 1945. The weekly was an instant success and earned lots of money. The weekly was a continuation, as is stated in its first issue, of the monthly Elsevier, which was founded in 1891 to promote the name of the publishing house and had to stop publication in December 1940 because of the Nazi occupation in 1947. Elsevier began publishing its first English-language journal, Biochimica et Biophysica Acta, in 2013. Elsevier acquired Mendeley, a UK company making software for managing and sharing research papers. Mendeley, previously an open platform for sharing of research, was greatly criticized for the acquisition, which users saw as acceding to the paywall approach to research literature. Mendeley's previously open sharing system now allows exchange of paywalled resources only within private groups. The New Yorker described Elsevier's reasons for buying Mendeley as twofold: to acquire its user data, and to destroy or coopt an open science icon that threatens its business model. In December 2013, Elsevier announced a collaboration with University College, London, the UCL Big Data Institute. Elsevier's investment is substantial and thought to be more than £10 million. Company statistics in the primary research market during 2015. Researchers submitted over 13 meters research papers to Elsevier-based publications. Over 17,000 editors, almost all of them unpaid, manage the peer review and selection of these papers, resulting in the publication of more than 400,000 articles in over 2,500 journals in 2013. Elsevier, together with Springer, Wiley Blackwell, Taylor. Elsevier employs more than 7,200 people in over 70 offices across 24 countries. The company publishes 2,500 journals and 30,000 e-books. It is headed by Chief Executive Officer CEO Ron Mobed. In 2015, Elsevier accounted for 35% of the revenues of RELX Group. 2,070 billion liras of 5,971 billion liras in operating profits. It represented 42%, 760 million liras of 1,822 million liras adjusted operating profits with constant currency rose by 2% from 2014 to 2015 operating structure following the integration of its science. Engineering Village, Compendix, Cell, Civil, Pure, and Analytical Services, the Consult Series. First Consult, Path Consult, Nursing Consult, MD Consult, Student Consult, Virtual Clinical Excursions, and major reference works such as Gray's Anatomy, Nelson Pediatrics, Dorland's Illustrated Medical Dictionary, Netter's Atlas of Human Anatomy, and online versions of many journals including The Lancet. There are the following subsidiary imprints, many of them previously independent publishing companies: Academic Press, Butterworth Heinemann, CMP, Digital Press, Elsevier, Gulf Professional Publishing, Morgan Kaufman, Nunes, Pergamon Press, Pergamon Flexible Learning, Singris Publishing, William Andrew, Saunders, Mosby, Churchill Livingstone, Butterworth Heinemann, Hanley. Conferences a year covering life sciences, physical sciences. £1 million to Elsevier annually. The company has been criticized not only by advocates of a switch to the open access publication model, but also by universities whose library budgets make it difficult for them to afford current journal prices. For example, a resolution by Stanford University's Senate singled out Elsevier's journals as being disproportionately expensive compared to their educational and research value, which librarians should consider dropping, and encouraged its faculty not to contribute articles or editorial or review efforts to publishers and journals that engage in exploitive or exorbitant pricing. Similar guidelines and criticism of Elsevier's pricing policies have been passed by the University of California, Harvard University, and Duke University in July 2015. The Association of Universities in the Netherlands (VSNU) announced a plan to start boycotting Elsevier, which refused to negotiate on any open access policy for Dutch universities' resignation of editorial boards in November 1999. The entire editorial board, 50 persons of the Journal of Logic Programming, founded in 1984 by Alan Robinson, collectively resigned after 16 months of unsuccessful negotiations with Elsevier Press about the price of library subscriptions. The personnel created a new journal, Theory and Practice of Logic Programming, with Cambridge University Press at a much lower price, while Elsevier continued publication with a new editorial board and a slightly different name, the Journal of Logic and Algebraic Programming. In 2002, dissatisfaction at Elsevier's pricing policies caused the European Economic Association to terminate an agreement with Elsevier, designating Elsevier's European Economic Review as the official journal of the association. The EEA launched a new journal, the Journal of the European Economic Association, in 2003. The entire editorial board of the Journal of Algorithms resigned to start ACM Transactions on Algorithms with a different, lower-priced, not-for-profit publisher, at the suggestion of Journal of Algorithms founder Donald Knuth. The Journal of Algorithms continued under Elsevier with a new editorial board until October 2009, when it was discontinued. The same happened in 2005 to the International Journal of Solids and Structures, whose editors resigned to start the Journal of Mechanics of Materials and Structures. However, a new editorial board was quickly established and the journal continues in apparently unaltered form, with editors D.A. Hills, Oxford University, and Stelios Kyriakides, University of Texas at Austin. In August 2006, the entire editorial board of the distinguished mathematical journal Topology handed in their resignation, again because of stalled negotiations with Elsevier to lower the subscription price. This board then launched the new Journal of Topology at a far lower price, under the auspices of the London Mathematical Society. After this mass resignation, Topology remained in circulation under a new editorial board until 2009, when the last issue was published. The French École Normale Supérieure has stopped having Elsevier publish the journal Annales Scientifiques de l'École Normale Supérieure as of 2008. The elevated pricing of field journals in economics, most of which are published by Elsevier, was one of the motivations that moved the American Economic Association to launch the American Economic Journal in 2009. In May 2015, Stephen Leader was removed from his role as editor of the Medical Journal of Australia after its publisher decided to outsource the journal's production to Elsevier. As a consequence, all but one of the journal's editorial advisory committee members co-signed a letter of resignation in October 2015. The entire editorial staff of the general linguistics journal Lingua resigned in protest of Elsevier's unwillingness to agree to their terms of fair open access. Editor-in-chief Johan Rorick also announced that the Lingua staff would establish a new journal, Glossa Action Against Academics, posting their own articles online. Digimarc, a company representing Elsevier, recently told the University of Calgary to remove articles published by faculty authors on university web pages, although such self-archiving of academic articles may be legal under the fair dealing provisions in Canadian copyright law. The university complied. Harvard University and the University of California, Irvine also received takedown notices for self-archived academic articles, a first for Harvard. According to Peter Suber, months after its acquisition of AcadémiaDU rival Mendeley, Elsevier sent thousands of takedown notices to AcadémiaDU, a practice that has since ceased following widespread complaint by academics. According to AcadémiaDU founder and chief executive Richard Price, chaos, Soliton's affiliations with certain international institutions. The suit came to trial in November 2011 and was dismissed in July 2012, with the judge ruling that the article was substantially true, contained honest comment, and was the product of responsible journalism. The judgment noted that El-Naschi, who represented himself in court, had failed to provide any documentary evidence that his papers had been peer-reviewed. Judge Victoria Sharp also found reasonable and serious grounds for suspecting that El-Naschi used a range of false names to defend his editorial practice in Communications with Nature, and described this behavior as curious and bizarre. Sponsored journal's main article, Australasian Journal of Bone. Behalf of pharmaceutical clients, that were made to look like journals and lacked the proper disclosures. The statement acknowledged that it was an unacceptable practice. The scientist reported that, according to an Elsevier spokesperson, six sponsored publications were put out by their Australia office and bore the Excerpta Medica imprint from 2000 to 2005, namely the Australasian Journal of Bone and Joint Medicine Australis J Bone Joint Med, the Australasian Journal of General Practice Australis J Gen Pract, the Australasian Journal of Neurology Australis J Neural, the Australasian Journal of Cardiology Australis J Cardiol, the Australasian Journal of Clinical Pharmacy Australis J Clin Pharm, and the Australasian Journal of Cardiovascular Medicine Australis J Cardiovasc Med. Excerpta Medica was a strategic medical communications agency run by Elsevier. According to the imprint's web page in October 2010, Excerpta Medica was acquired by Adelphi Worldwide Shill Review Offer. According to the BBC, the firm offered a £1,725 Amazon voucher to academics who contributed to the textbook Clinical Psychology if they would go on Amazon.com and Barnes. Particular email went too far, and that it was a mistake by a marketing employee who's afraid of peer review. Main article, Who's Afraid of Peer Review. One of Elsevier's journals was caught in the sting set up by John Bohannon, published in Science, called Who's Afraid of Peer Review. The journal Drug Invention Today accepted an obviously bogus paper made up by Bohannon that should have been rejected by any good peer review system instead. Drug Invention Today was among many open access journals that accepted the fake paper for publication as of 2014, this journal had been transferred to a different publisher. The Cost of Knowledge boycott. Main article, The Cost of Knowledge. In 2003, various university librarians began coordinating with each other to complain about Elsevier's Big Deal journal bundling packages, in which the company offered a group of journal subscriptions to libraries at a certain rate, but in which librarians claimed there was no economical option to subscribe to only the popular journals at a rate comparable to the bundled rate. Librarians continued to discuss the implications of the pricing schemes, many feeling pressured into buying the Elsevier packages without other options. On 21 January 2012, mathematician Timothy Gowers publicly announced he would boycott Elsevier, noting that others in the field have been doing so privately. The three reasons for the boycott are high subscription prices for individual journals, bundling subscriptions to journals of different value and importance, and Elsevier's support for SOPA, PIPA, and the Research Works Act. Following this, a petition advocating non-cooperation with Elsevier, that is, not submitting papers to Elsevier journals, not refereeing articles in Elsevier journals, and not participating in journal editorial boards, appeared on the site, The Cost of Knowledge. By February 2012, this petition had been signed by over 5,000 academics, growing to over 13,000 by January 2013. Elsevier disputed the claims, arguing that their prices are below the industry average, and stating that bundling is only one of several different options available to buy access to Elsevier journals. The company also claimed that its profit margins are simply a consequence of the firm's efficient operation. On 27 February 2012, Elsevier issued a statement on its website that declared that it has withdrawn support from the Research Works Act. Although the Cost of Knowledge movement was not mentioned, the statement indicated the hope that the move would help create a less heated and more productive climate for ongoing discussions with research funders. Hours after Elsevier's statement, the sponsors of the bill, U.S. House Representatives Daryl Issa and Carolyn Maloney, issued a joint statement saying that they would not push the bill in Congress selling open access articles. In 2014, Elsevier was found to be selling some articles which should have been open access, but had been put behind a paywall. A related case occurred in 2015, when Elsevier charged for downloading an open access article from a journal published by John Wiley. Imprints are brand names in publishing. Elsevier uses its imprints to market to different consumer segments. Many of them have previously been the company names of publishers that were purchased by Reed. Elsevier Academic Press, Baillier, Tyndall, BC Decker, Butterworth, Heinemann, Cell Press, Churchill, Livingstone, Gulf Professional Publishing, GW Medical Publishing, Hanley Pergamon Press, Saunders Singris, William Andrew Woodhead Publishing, including Chandos and Horwood C. Also Netherlands Portal Companies, Portal Books, Portal List of Elsevier Periodicals. 2 Collab, a free researcher collaboration tool launched by Elsevier in 2007 and discontinued in 2011. Sci-Hub, an open access website providing free access to paywalled academic papers on a massive scale that's involved in a legal case with Elsevier. References ABCDEFGH 2015 RELX Group Annual Report. PDF RELX Group Company Reports RELX Group March 2016. Carrot https://dubcom/content/dam/account/and/marketing-cloud/campaign-management/pdf/adobe-campaign-customer-story-elsevierpdf PDF. Carrot Read Elsevier announces knowledge partnership with University College, London. The Independent, the 18th of December 2013, retrieved the 29th of September 2014 subscription required help. Bookseller, the 2nd of February 2016, retrieved the 4th of February 2016. The Journal of Algorithms PDF retrieved the 18th of February 2008. Carrot Topology page at ScienceDirect. ScienceDirect.com retrieved the 26th of December 2013. September 2015. Carrot Grant, Bob, the 30th of April 2009. Merck published fake journal. The Scientist retrieved the 4th of May 2009. Carrot Bohannon, John, Chapter 2013. Who's Afraid of Peer Review? Science 342 6154-60-65. Bibcode 2013Sci3420B DOI 101126. Science 342615460 PMID. Carrot Elsevier backs down as boycott grows. Retrieved the 25th of August 2014. Carrot Simba Information, 5 Professional Publishing News Events of 2015. Signal Times are a Chang'an PR Newswire, the 17th of December 2015, retrieved the 28th of June 2016. Elsevier Imprints Academic Press, Anderson Baylier, Tyndall Butterworth, Hyman Cell Press, Chandos Publishing, Churchill Livingstone, Current Opinion, Gulf Professional Publishers, Hanley. Security Executive Council, Singris Urban. HESI Novel Mendeley Reaxes ScienceDirect Scopus SSRN LexisNexis Butterworths CaseMap JurisClasser Law 360 LexisNexis Risk Solutions Martindale Hubble Matthew Bender Quicklaw Shepherd Citations Tolly. Zap Read Business Information Germany Detail Netherlands All About Feed Belegers Belangen Biz Borderage Elsevier Meat International Pig Progress World Poultry United Kingdom Airline Business BankerSalmonak Community Care Employers Law Estates Gazette Farmers Weekly Flight International ICIS Irish Medical Times KellySearch MIMS Ireland New Scientist Personnel Today Poultry World X Perther Zib United States CMD 49% Read Exhibitions Arabian Travel Market Chicago Comic Equitana Global Gaming Expo MIPCOM MIPIM New York Comic Con London Book Fair Penny Arcade Expo World Travel Market Category Authority Control WorldCat Identities VIAF, 152,166,420 ISNI, 0000-0001-0672-9757 GND, 4,250,271-8 Sudik, 02988-3091 BN NF, CB 121,414,808 data.